It's you, Crane. I've seen your face on the posters. You've got to help me.
What happened to you?
I took a bullet from Razor's men. I'm a runner too. Well, almost. Look, I'm out of commission. Can you help me out? I need you to finish this run for me.
Look, I'll get you to a shelter or something, but I've got other things to take care of.
You don't have anything more important than this, I guarantee it.
All right. Tell me what you got.
The source of the epidemic.
Where?
David can show you. Here's a list and a bag with the things I already collected. The rest is on you. When you've got it all, take it to David. He'll tell you everything. You'll find him at the Royal Canal. Tell him Spider sent you.
What about you?
I've got a safe house nearby. I'll be fine. Just help David. That's all that matters.
Thank you. It's one of us. He's dead.
Trying to help him! Kill him!
Stop. Don't let me die here! Thanks! I owe you!
About time!
Who are you?
Crane, Spider sent me.
Why? What's happened to him?
He ran into Rice's people, but he'll be all right. Look, I brought the things he was collecting for you.
You're a lifesaver. Thanks, Crane. This is really going to make a difference.
So, tell me what this is all about.
Oh, I thought you knew.
I know it involves the source of the epidemic.
Yes, the meteorite. I know where it landed.
You think the epidemic came from space?
You think that's a coincidence?
You have some proof of this?
I did. Rice's men just took off with my last samples. I was going to send Spider out for some more. Could you do it?
But I reached the site. I don't see anything.
All right, listen. The meteor shards react to green light. That makes them easier to spot. The Azmat guys put up some lamps and a generator. They should still be working.
Oh, hell. Should probably stop pulling this trigger.
Yeah!
Oh, God.
I've got your meteor fragments.
Good. I'll load the shards into the accelerator chamber, and we'll be ready to take the fight to the reptilians.
Whoa, wait, whoa. Who are we taking the fight to?
Okay, technically they're Gadoids from Orion, but reptilians is a recognized euphemism, even if it's a bit redneck.
Uh-huh. And these Gadoids did what now?
Please. They came to Earth eons ago. And formed the Order of the Illuminati. Now they want to dominate us and spread around the entire fourth level. They have been turning people into slaves. But now you're going to stop them, because you have this.
I do?
Remember, it's not going to cut through a fast variable gamma shield, but short of that, it should deatomize anything out there.
Right. Got it. Anything else?
I'd estimate you can count on 500 charges before you need to replace the meteor shards. So go get them, soldier. Send them to hell. Envoyez-les à l'enfer.
Gee, thanks, David. Thanks a lot.
special deal for you.
I don't like American movies. Not anymore.
Sorry, I didn't hear you. What'd you say?
American movies. My mother took me. Always on Thursday nights, after she got home from work. She would take me and my little brother to the cinema. We love the movies from your country.
You won't find better deals in all of Haran.
You've got Mail, The Matrix, Singing in the Rain. Oh, especially Singing in the Rain. We loved them. We loved Haran, too. But our city was nothing like the sights your film showed us.
Oh, so, what went wrong?
What went wrong? You know what went wrong.
You won't find better stuff anywhere else.
Venture outside and it becomes painfully obvious. But that is not why I dislike American movies now. I dislike them because they betrayed me. They promised me, how do you say it? A Hollywood ending. Everyone lives happily ever
after. Better stuff anywhere else.
There is no such thing. We are born, and then we die. And we never know when or how it's going to happen. Your happy stories did not prepare me for that. I wish they had. I wish they had. You can keep your Hollywood ending. I must live in the real world now.
You won't find better deals in all of Haran.
Your nemesis awaits you. He has waited a long time.
That sounds like you've met him.
He once sought my visions for his advantage, but I will not share my gift with such a man as him. With you, I will.
How much will that cost?
The price will be high, but your payment will not be to me. Now you will go to the river. There is a pungent nightshade that reveals itself only in the moonlight. The smolder of its embers enables the seeker to pierce the veil.
All out, are we?
Bring me several stalks of this plant.
Maybe I will. But in the meantime, you should shut off the music. It draws attention.
Nothing enters that I do not wish. Now, I must prepare my mind.
Ooh.
Place the stalks in the brazier, and we will begin.
Now what happens?
Speak no more. The rising sun will lead you to the Fountain of Crying Blood, near the place where people are speaking tongues. You must follow the red trail to be enlightened. Under the deceitful number 9, the shadow of a self-proclaimed king will be waiting for you. The king with whom you shall have to fight. You'll find out who he is and what his weaknesses are. When the time comes, you will take his crown or die.
Ah! I've got 2 days left, tops. I need the subs.
Well, he's either clairvoyant or I'm being set up. Guess the deceitful nine must be a room number then.
Gah!
Deceitful Nine, of course. This was Rice's room. He must have set up shop here when the epidemic first began.
Crane, I'm Mort Norris, worked in the town hall before the outbreak. Modernization of maintenance of hydraulic infrastructure department. One hell of a job, I'm telling you. Miss it more than I miss my kids these days.
Okay. So, you wanted to ask me something?
Yes, I was supposed to get water running in my neighborhood again, but I can't because of those damn undead and it's killing me. Could I persuade you to do it, please? It would be a great civic gesture, appreciated by tens, maybe dozens of people.
Oh, what would I need to do?
Just redirect the flow of water again. That's all. It'll be such a help. It'll even get our beautiful fountain up and running again.
Yeah, right. So what do you want me to do then?
Great. Great, fantastic. You just have to get to these three pumping stations and switch the valves. Here, I'll show you where they are.
Thank you. I never expected Haran's destiny to turn out so close to its intention. And yet, so far,
What do you mean?
Haran has always been something of an anomaly. It was originally settled in the Middle Ages, but it has always been an open city, a center of trade and commerce. Because of that, the prevailing attitude here has consistently been one of tolerance and acceptance. People of all nationalities, ethnicities, religions, all were welcome within Haran's borders, as long as they could pay the city's taxes.
Sounds like a good thing.
You would think. And for the most part, it has been. The aborted global athletics games would have highlighted the city's diversity.
So why do you sound so down about it?
Because the outbreak has demonstrated what I fear is one of the more fundamental elements of human nature. We divide ourselves. We divide ourselves and we look for an enemy. The survivors in the tower are a diverse lot, it's true. But who are we more frightened of? The infected? Or Ryze and his army of gangsters? And Ryze himself? I'm told his men are just as varied as those of us here. And yet, he sends them against us. If old lines fade, we draw new lines.
Okay, well, thanks for that bit of inspiration. I've switched all three valves.
Brilliant. Now, you just have to do the same in the main pumping station. Give me a shout once you're there.
Okay, what now?
Look for the main valve.
Hey, look over there.
Done. Mort, any progress?
Yes, yes! We've got water again. Not just in our building, but in my whole district, too. You did my job and you did it well. Even the fountain works again. Amazing, Crane.
Good. That's better to drink water than energy drinks.